here today on our 34 foot Black Watch Black Magic. Now we've just had our 3 foot Halo Pulse Compression Radar installed, and we thought what better way to showcase it than out here on glorious Botany Bay. We've got Ken from Simrad with us here today, and we're going to show you a few of the neat little features the Halo has to offer. How you going, Ken?
Good, mate. Yourself?
Good, mate. Good.
If we look on the radar screen here now, sitting in the middle of Botany Bay, as you say, we've got what we call target trails turned on, and the target trails shows you anything that's moving as leaving little dots behind it, like when you're doing your GPS when you drive along.
Yep, and mate, you can see here right now, there's an aeroplane that's just coming in with a trail. Aeroplane out there behind us, and you can see it coming in here to land on the runway. Pretty cool stuff.
Yeah, you can see how fast it's going compared to the other boats in the area that are moving around as well.
Yeah, you can see the clarity, like you can see the shape of Botany Bay there. And over here on our GPS, it's pretty much the exact same image, just on the radar screen. So one of the cool features about the Simrad Halo Radar is the different modes that you can set it in. So it's got harbour mode, offshore mode, bird mode, and weather mode. Being game fishermen, that bird mode is a really neat little function. So we'll just get Ken to talk about the different modes and how they work.
Yeah, sure. So as you mentioned, harbour mode, obviously we're in the harbour now, yep. Run it in harbour mode, it's very simple, it looks for every little thing, even your crab pot floats and all that sort of stuff will show up on the screen. Offshore mode, pretty simple again, offshore meaning you're offshore. If you're offshore and you're getting lots of white caps and rough conditions, put it into offshore mode and it will help get rid of those white caps so you can still see it.
Turns the sensitivity down a little bit by itself, that way you're picking up the objects rather than the white caps.
Yeah,
white
reduces sea clutter.
Yep.
Weather mode, another obvious one as well. That's really cool when you're watching weather squalls, rain fronts and stuff coming through.
Yep.
You can track them from 48 nautical miles away with this 3 foot antenna. And then of course bird mode, but you can see how fast the radar's spinning now in harbour mode. If I put it into bird mode, you actually hear the radar
slowing down.
That goes right to 16 RPM. That 16 RPM means you're getting more time or more energy on the targets, i.e. the birds.
Yep.
So birds at 5-6 nautical miles away, especially clustered on, will start to show up as a nice big signal on the screen to pick up. Then you just have to trust in the product and drive over towards it and find those fish.
Now that's a really neat function if you're chasing tuna offshore and you want to find schools of bird. Obviously you're not going to see them unless they're close to you. With the radar, up to 6 nautical miles away, you can pick up clusters of birds, go over, find the tuna, and hopefully hook up one. The other cool thing about here, we can see our AIS targets are all locked on as well, so it's not just the radar, it's talking with the entire system, and you can see our AIS boat targets sitting on the screen as well. We've got a ship just behind us here, and that's coming up on our radar screen. One of the really cool features I love about the Halo is the target lock. So we can find a target on our radar, such as a fishing boat, put a lock on it, and then it will follow that boat around as long as it remains in range. So we might just get Ken to show us how that's done. We've got a sailing boat here just behind us, Kenny. So maybe we can get a lock on him and we'll follow him as he enters the bay.
Sounds like a plan. Simple enough. All you need to do is put the cursor onto the screen, and this is the yacht coming towards us just there now. Hit the menu button, go to acquire target, and it locks onto it there.
Wow.
You'll see a square around it until it locks on. When it's locked on, it's a circle.
So you can see in here now, it's locked onto it, and that'll follow that around with a little circle or a triangle around it, and that way we always know where he is on the screen. So the Simrad Halo Radar we have on this boat is a 3 foot model, but there are other versions available, Kenny?
Yeah, there's a 4 and a 6 foot one as well, which give you better definition and longer range out of them as well.
Yep.
And if you're after more information, jump on the simrad-yachting.com website, look up your local dealer, and we should be able to get a lot more information there as well.
Cool.